Again, we're going to continue along with our OXO brush model here as it gets increasingly stranger and diverges more from what the original product looks like. And in this case, I want to show how you can add additional surface features using the filled surface command. What I'm going to do here to start is we had knit the surface bodies together at the end of the last tutorial in order to convert from surface bodies back to a single solid body. I'm actually going to get rid of that. I'm going to just suppress it because I actually want to keep working with surface bodies. So you can see that this model is now, most of it is this one surface body, but there's these two here as well. Okay, so let's say for some unknown reason I want to add these little protrusions or wings to the sides of the heads of this brush. I'm going to do that using the filled surface technique. So again, we're going to define a region that we're going to cut away from our existing surface and replace it with something else. In this case, I'm going to draw a profile on the right plane here. And I'm just going to do something like this. It's a little large, but this should work. Okay. Now, in this case, I mentioned last time that I wanted to use the trim tool, but was not able to because I was starting with a solid body. In this case, we're starting with a surface body, so I can use the trim tool. Trim is just basically it's a shortcut for establishing a split line and then deleting selected faces. So I'm going to use my trim surface tool. My trim tool is the sketch that I had drawn, which I'll select over here. And then you can either say, I want to choose what I'm going to keep, or I'm going to choose what I'm going to remove. And in this case, it's just easier for me to choose what I'm going to remove. So I'm going to click on this area here, and this area here. You can see that it's just projecting that sketch out normal to its sketch plane, and it's intersecting the surface at these two places. So I'm selecting these two regions as parts of the surface that I'm going to trim away. So after doing that, we have these holes in the side of the brush. So filled surface basically allows you to define a perimeter, and it's going to fill it back in. So if we just did this, I also need to mention that filled surface can be very taxing on your computer because there's a lot of math going on. You can see that this is the mesh that it has created to try to figure out how it can most efficiently fill in this profile. So let's see what would happen if I just went with that. All right, well, that's not all that exciting. It could be what you want because this is a different surface than the original one. It's not as curved out like this because basically it's just trying to contact all the edges and use, I think the algorithm is that it's trying to use as little material as possible to accomplish that. If we switch to our zebra stripes, we see that there's a very clear change in the surface there. Okay, so maybe that's not what we wanted here. Let's go back and edit this feature. One thing I do want to show before we continue is by default, it's trying to contact all the edges, but you can also tell it to try to keep tangency. Now, this makes the computer have to think even more, but basically, what you're going to get here is a patch that has a smoother connection with the surface around it. And I think in most cases, if you just cut out from a surface and then patch it with tangency set, you'll basically end up with the same surface you had in the first place. Okay. Just wanted to show that. So let's go back and edit again. I'm actually intending for what we're going to do to be a protrusion, so I don't want tangency. I want it to, this will be a different part of the surface that's clearly different from the original. What I am interested in doing is using constraint curves to make this bulge out in a certain way. So before we can do that, I have to draw those curves. So I'm going to rewind up before this fill so that I can establish those that sketch first. Now, basically, with these constraints for the filled surface, it almost always works best just to use points. So I'm going to do a sketch that just has points in it. Once you start doing splines and lines and other things, it gets a lot harder for the computer to figure out how to use that information as a constraint. And a lot of times the feature will fail. You can usually get what you want just using points. Now, I don't have a plane out here right now. Well, I suppose... I'd have to make something parallel to this top plane to try to get points out here in space where I want them to be. This is actually a good time to break out the 3D sketch tool, though, because that's going to allow me to put points exactly where I want out in space without having to worry about being on a certain plane. So I'm going to go ahead and start a 3D sketch. And when I'm 3D sketching, I almost always try to stick to the orthographic views, just to avoid getting all tangled up. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to get a top view, and I'm going to put a point there, and I'm going to put a point there. And these probably need to be a little closer, actually. Okay, so I'm just positioning them right from the top view. Now I'm going to switch to a side view. And actually, they weren't that far off. These could have been at any altitude here, because, again, we're not sketching on a plane anymore. So I'm going to move this one down here, and I'm going to move this one here. I'm going to go back to my top view, make sure nothing got out of control. Side view looks all right. I suspect the front is fine, yeah. Okay, so those are about in the right place. I'm going to exit my 3D sketch. And now this sketch has these guide points that I want to use to affect that filled surface. So let's go back and edit our filled surface feature again. Constraint curves. I'm going to select that 3D sketch. Now it looks like I was a little too ambitious, and I think these points are probably a little too far out, or they're too close to the edges or something. It looks like it's not able to accommodate that. So let's go and edit this sketch again. I'm going to go back to my top view. And I'm going to try to move these in a little closer. I don't want to get a constraint like that. It didn't automatically. Oh, see. This is one problem with 3D sketches. When you have, sketch settings, enable snapping turned on, it's going to snap to all kinds of stuff that you don't want. So I'm going to undo that. And let's see. My left view, top view. I'm going to try to do this again without snapping there. Actually, I'm going to go in here. Okay, that's a little more conservative. Let's see if this is going to work. Edit feature. Will it allow me? Yes, okay. So what's happened here is it's doing the surface patch, but it's also requiring the surface to go through those two points that I had established. So when we do that, now we have these kind of bumpy wing-looking thing, or one of the two, sticking out of the side of the handle. And, you know, I could, if I wanted it to be flatter along here, I could have added a third constraint point that's more in here to kind of balance out the other two. There's a lot you can affect using points. Although the more points you use and the farther they are away from the original surface or the closer they are to these edges, the less likely it is to work. So it's just something that you have to experiment with. So I'm going to select this and I'm going to mirror it over. I'm going to mirror this body across the right plane. And again, I want to, let's see. Well, I'm not going to knit this whole thing together into solid, but what I do want to do is say I wanted to fillet this just to smooth that out a bit. I do have a fillet command on my surface toolbar here, but in this case it's not going to work because these are different surface bodies. In order to create a fillet here, they have to be the same surface body. So I'm actually just going to knit together, just by way of example, I'm just going to knit together these three faces. I'm not going to say try to form solid. Okay, so I've got these. Notice that I've now ended up duplicating. I've got surfaces on top of one another because those originals are still there. I had just knit faces together to one another, but you know the original surfaces are still there. I just want to show this as an example, so I'm gonna hide this away. So now I've just got one layer of surfaces here. Now I can select these edges and do a fillet. Just do like this. Okay. So that's how I can fill it between adjacent surface bodies. So that's the filled surface with constraint curves.